Returning now to our top story tonight, the managing director of the law firm taking the unsolved test case says as far as she's concerned, it will still be heard at the High Court in Christchurch in 10 days. Angela Parlane of Shine Lawyers says she only learned the case was abandoned when she watched Grant Robertson announce it during RNZ's live stream this afternoon. Shine Lawyers represents more than 50 homeowners who unknowingly purchased homes with botched EQC repairs. Those homeowners, known as unsolds, include the Gibling family, who are the test case. The Giblings used their KiwiSaver savings to buy their first home, only to find it needed $300,000 in repairs. A short time ago, Angela Parlane told me she's proceeding as if the Giblings case is still going ahead.
I don't know that it has been dropped, you see, that's what I'm saying. We have not received anything from any party, apart from seeing this news release, to say it's been dropped. So we are still proceeding as if it's going to kick off on the 26th of August. So until such time as we receive a notice of, in fact, we're the plaintiffs, so we would have to file a notice of discontinuance for that case to be dropped, and there'd have to be a settlement. And so as far as we're concerned, at this point, the case is still proceeding.
Has your client been notified that the case is not going ahead?
Well, as I say, we are acting as if the case is still going ahead because we haven't heard otherwise from a source other than a media release. So we can't just rely upon a media release to say that the case is dropped.
I'm wondering, could EQC have, well, could they have made a quiet offer to your client?
It is possible, but our client is also telling us that he's going to court on the 26th of August with us. So until such time as we hear otherwise, the case is going ahead. I think the important thing about this is that what we do have, putting the case to one side, is an announcement from the government that they are going to do something really positive for all of those homeowners that we act for, plus other Cantabrians who have bought houses that have been repaired by EQC. I think that's the more important part of the press release rather than the actual test case, because we're in this particularly tricky phase where the test case is very close to the court date. There's been a media release at around 3 o'clock, and various parties haven't got their ducks in a row to discuss things related to the test case, but the announcement from the government that they intend to do something about the unsold homeowners is fantastic. And we've been fighting for these people for a few years now. We have approximately 57 clients who will be delighted that EQC is doing something to put them in the position that they ought to have been in originally. So it's great news.
Do you have confidence in this new process that's been announced, given that, as you point out, your clients have been wrangling with EQC for a number of years, and while the government set up the pool of cash, they will still have to go through EQC to get it, to agree on the amount that's paid out and to agree on the repairs that are required? So is it an advance?
Well, we have every confidence that this process will put in place something that does allow homeowners to be put in the position they ought to have been in when they purchased their houses. However, we don't know the details and how that's going to take place. So if it's some kind of little scheme whereby they're just going to make nominal offers, I think they're calling them ex gratia payments, if they're going to be small payments that aren't actually going to fix the damage, then that's not going to work for homeowners.
There's no admission of liability here. And Grant Robertson said there was, the thinking was there needed to be a line in the sand and an opportunity to move on, but there is no admission of liability. Is that enough?
Well, that's the very reason that the test case is still proceeding. Because there is no admission of liability. So the test case, one of the main things I can say is that we are endeavouring to establish that the Earthquake Commission owes the on-sold owners a duty of care, and that is the whole point of the test case. So, you know, we're 2 weeks away from trial, and this new scheme is suggesting that there's no liability on the part of EQC, so we'll just have to see how that pans out.
Just to be clear, Angela, do you think it's essential that an admission of liability is established?
Again, it would depend on what the offers made by EQC are. Certainly our test case was to establish that EQC owes a duty of care, and we're still working towards that until we hear otherwise.
So if they lowball your clients, you may still have to go the distance.
Absolutely.
And that's Angela Parlane from Shine Lawyers, who was taking the test case on behalf of the on-solds.